Everybody, it's Invicta, it's time for another Solo Queue Silliness here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be playing as Illidan, and on our team today, we have H to the Husky Husky playing as Malfurion. I'm scared already, considering that he picked the wrong Albithor build that I gave him last time. Hopefully, he doesn't pick the wrong Malfurion build, but if he does, we'll just make fun of him for it. So, Malfurion played by Husky, myself on Illidan, Vala, Sonya, Johanna, going up against Nubrok, Rhaegar, Johanna, Raynor, and Sylvanas. So, I think everyone does know that Illidan is pretty much my favorite character in the game. He's been my main for quite a long time. And, to be honest, I don't see it changing anytime soon. Since we are on Sky Temple, it's a very big map. It's big enough for me to go for Seasoned Marksman because I'm going to be bouncing around all kinds of sorts of lane here. All kinds of sorts of lanes. Also, that little falcon, whatever that is, he looked dead for a second. I don't know, that was kind of weird. Anyway, I'm going to be going for my normal hunt spec, the Sinvicta Infinite Hunt build, which has been it's been pretty much a standard of mine now for the past couple of months, actually. Maybe not months. That might be a little bit of an exaggeration, but it's been this way for a little while now. Let's put it that way, at least a month. Whenever the Infinite Hunt spec came out that I put on YouTube, that's the one that it was after that point where I started to actually just do the spec non-stop. And I'm certainly not planning on stopping now. Nice route there by Husky, actually, although I am going to have to back up because of the simple fact that there is Raynor right there. And the enemy team actually going pretty hard here on this top lane. Sonya is going to be going against Johanna on the enemy team in the bot lane. Again, another nice route there by Husky. I do want to make sure I don't get hit by the impaling blades from a new Barak, if I can help it, like that. Luckily, Illidan does have some pretty good, he's got some pretty good counter contingency plans when it comes to avoiding skill shots. Like using dive, like using sweeping strike, etc. Husky's going to go ahead and tap the fountain. I think I'm going to do that as well. Again, I can't really go too hard right now because of the simple fact that it is a 3v2 up here. And I know that Husky and I are good enough to fight 2-on-2, but not 3-on-2. Especially now that Sylvanas came up here. That's going to be a 4-on-2, so I'm just going to kind of soak in lane right now and wait to see if they're going to transition from the top to the mid. We can't really take down the top right now. Sonya, where are you going, Sonya? Where are you going, Sonya? Unfortunately, I missed my sweeping strike on top of Sylvanas there. Whoa, I'm going to go after a new Nubrok to try to discourage him from killing Sonya, because he definitely could have. Meanwhile, our Vala player and Johanna are still taking down the middle, which is good. I'm still going to be getting stacks here of Seasoned Marksman. Seasoned Marksman, by the way, is going to increase it's going to permanently increase my basic attack damage by one every single time. Is it by one or by two? I think it's by two. No, it is by one. With every single, you'd think I know this by now, but the game changes so much, sometimes I miss a couple things. With every six things that die, or every three enemies that die around me, I will gain a stack of permanent increased basic attack damage, which is very, very good for Illidan, especially considering that he is a basic attack hero. And let's go see if we can mess with, I'm going to try to keep him honest. I'm not going to try to do much here. Let's see if Rhaegar tries to get cute with the Earthbind Totem or not. Husky's going to throw a regrowth on me. So we end up trading weapon. Oh, what a nice route by Husky. We're not going to be able to kill them, but that is going to make sure that they get pushed back off of the cap here. I'm going to do a little bit of damage to Sylvanas. And I'm going to try not to die to Sylvanas here. All right, well. You should drink from a fountain while you're still eating. I would drink from a fountain there, big brother, except I can't. I'm going to go ahead and tap the fountain instead. So, right now, we are currently barely leading on levels, but not that much. It is nice that we both did, or each team did get a little bit of a map objective trade there. I'm going to stay up in lane right now, just so I can soak XP. On top of that, making sure I'm getting the good old-fashioned Seasoned Marksman. Sylvanas should know that she is not going to be able to trade with Illidan. She kind of actually goofed there on the Haunting Wave, but unfortunately, that stop bug still exists on Illidan. Man, that is so annoying. The stop bug, by the way, sometimes when Illidan uses Sweeping Strike, he will actually just stop doing everything. He'll stop moving, he'll stop attacking. It's almost as if you put him on the hold position command without him actually auto-attacking anything in range. That's exactly what happened. And that actually saved the Sylvanas' life because she goofed the micro on the Haunting Wave, and actually she just kind of did it again there. I probably could have gone after it and probably killed her. I'm going to go for Thrill of Battle. Of course, Thrill of Battle is my bread and butter of this build. That's the reason why I call it the Infinite Hunt. because all my cooldowns are greatly reduced, and I will be able to basically rattle off the hunt every single time it's up. Which it equates to right around roughly 30 seconds. I can hunt twice a minute, let's put it that way, under perfect conditions. It's not always like that. I call it the infinite hunt spec, but it's not technically truly infinite. But under perfect conditions, assuming that I have a target that I can auto-attack that doesn't die immediately, and I have my full duration of Betrayal's Thirst, I theoretically should be able to hunt twice per minute. And this is going to be all kinds of bad for the enemy team here. I did use the Thrill for Battle, and I'm just going to go after Rhaegar. Rhaegar's going to die instantly. Here comes Jimmy, and I'm going to go right on top of Anubarak just because I don't feel like messing with Jimmy next to the turret. Try to get the cap here. But you see how much power Illidan has whenever he does take the Thrill for Battle. Thrill for Battle, by the way, turns his trait into an on-use ability, which will double the amount of cooldown reduction he gets from auto attacks. And let's go see. So Vaughn's going to try to fake out here, possibly. There's no one capping the tower right now, so I'm not too worried about chasing them. I do see Jimmy going back over here. And so Vaughn was taken out eventually. I do need to be careful because here comes the enemy team. They're going to be re-engaging here on the tower. Where's our Vala going? There we go. I am going to go right after Jimmy if I can. And I did use the Thrill for Battle, and he is not going to be able to make it. Down goes Jimmy. I'm going to go after Rhaegar as well. Again, Thrill for Battle is still activated, and I'm getting so much cooldown reduction. I do not want to fight, however, in front of their turret. Especially with Johanna here being able to take me back into the guns. Anubarak is also going to go down, and I'm just going to basic attack myself back up to, well, not full, but kind of full. Thrill for Battle is back up. I'm going to go a little bit of a dive here on top of Sylvanas, and she is not going to be able to get away. See you later. Down she goes to the infinite hunt. Husky on top of the regrowth. Very nicely done. Already 36 seconds left on the hunt, and when that comes back up, get ready to see all my cooldowns rapidly decrease. Here we go. I did just use it. And watch the hunt. It's going to be done here. Yeah, just three hits. There you go. That's what I love about Thrill for Battle, which is the reason why I decided to incorporate it in my permanent spec, in my standard spec, whenever I do play as Illidan. Well done. So the hunt's already back up. Thrill for Battle is also already back up, and we can easily go engage the top here whenever we want. I told him that I can. The reason why I ping there is not because I'm on the way, but it's because I can go up there anytime I want. So nice stun there by Johanna. She is going to get taken out. I'm not even going to use Thrill for Battle here. As Vala is going to go down, I should be able to stop. Yeah, there we go. So I'm going to use Thrill for Battle here just so I can get a little bit of extra basic attacking off. I mean, it's you might as well be considering Johanna a raid boss that I can just auto-attack and get my cooldowns refreshed. The hunt already down to 26 seconds and counting. That's why I love it. Admittedly, the infinite spec that I do does not work as well with Metamorphosis just because of the simple fact that... Metamorphosis does have a much longer cooldown than the hunt. Plus, it doesn't really mesh well with what I try to do for the hunt spec. I do things a little bit differently. I'm not gonna go after Sylvanas here. I am gonna go after Raynor, however, because I do have Thrill for Battle back up. Again, if I get in trouble, I can basically just dive to a wall and get on out of there. Banshee's gonna chase me. I should be able to auto attack them down, however. Now Furion is going to go down. And I got web wrapped by a new Anubarak. Get out of there, Illidan, if you can. Oh, come on! I hit sweeping strike, but unfortunately I collided with something, and then that ended up killing me. So the enemy team ends up coming right back. I'm not quite sure what ended up happening there. Arsonia is taking the top temple. I'm not sure how Husky died so quickly, but I wasn't really paying attention to much because I was just trying to get out of the way of the Banshees. But that was not a good engagement by our team for sure. So Raynor is plucking away down on the Jackal Temple. I'm gonna go right after Sylvanas here. Again, I did use Thrill for Battle, so all my cooldown reductions are currently doubled. For my basic attacks, and Sylvanas is not... Whoa! Unless if the stop bug happens again! Man, oh man, oh man. Gotta love it. Gotta love that bug, man. So at least this, at least I'm able to show you all that the bug still does exist and why it's such a huge problem for Illidan players. Man, that is so annoying. We were able to, we're still able to kill Sylvanas, but if she had gotten away from that, that would have been twice that the stop bug saved the Sylvanas player. Either way, though, the hunt's back up. We were able to rattle off most of the charges on the Crocodile Temple. And right now I'm sitting at 19 stacks at 9 minutes. We're just barely behind the curve, actually. We should be at 20 stacks right now, and I'm just going to go after Johanna one-on-one here. I did use Thrill for Battle, again, just so I can get my, just so I can get the hunt back up as fast as possible. And Johanna does not really want to mess. And again, man, I don't know what's going on. Nice route there by Husky, though. But wow, that's the third time, second time in a row, second dive in a row, that the stop command bug is active on me. I'm gonna try to get out of there. Husky's gonna try to save me, but yeah, there's nothing I can do about that. So I should have been able to kill Johanna there, but unfortunately, right after using that dive, Illidan just stopped again. And that's becoming a serious problem. Now, as we died to that, I should not have died right there. Husky's gonna use Tranquility here. And Johanna's not gonna be able to kill the enemy Sylvanas, unfortunately. Our Sonya has not been here for pretty much any team fight, which is unfortunate because we could definitely use the, we can use the muscle. Of course, our Johanna got a little bit too overzealous there. Although, if Sylvanas is going to stick around, I'm going to take a free kill if I can. I'll take a couple free kills here. Jimmy's also not going to be able to escape me. There we go. The enemy team overextended a little too much and ended up paying the price for it. There we go. So, Husky's going to go take down the night camp. I'm going to go straight to the temples here after I get caught up in stacks. Again, I try to use Thrill for Battle pretty much every single time I get, or every single chance I get, because I do want to make sure that I have the hunt back off of cooldown and ready to go for the next fight. I still take Blood for Blood at level 16 just because of the, it's still a good way to execute, and if Illidan needs a heal, a quick burst heal, he can get it if he needs it. Sonya now distracting the enemy team on the bot lane. And at 12 minutes, we're at 24 stacks, so we're right on the money as far as our average goes. There we go. And we should definitely go help out mid. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to help that out. Sonya's already dead. We're just going to have to trade one tower for one temple for one temple here. The faster Vol and I clear the top temple, the faster we can go fight in that team fight. Gonna go right after Sylvanas here, and there's Blood for Blood. I use it right on top of her. Gonna go right after Rhaegar here. Here comes Johanna coming in from the side. I want to get away from Condemn because I knew she was gonna cast it. We're gonna go back in, not on Johanna, but go after Rhaegar because he's the squishiest out of the three. And if a new Barak is gonna get caught, oh, a new Barak ran right into the roots. I did get Thrill for Battle back up right at the last second there, so whoa, there you go. I was going to say, I can't believe that Anubarak is still alive. Still going to go after Raynor here. He's going to get taken out, and that is going to be it for the enemy team, at least three of them anyway. We should capture this mercenary camp. Taking the boss camp's pretty good idea. I'm going to try to get a couple of extra stacks here while I can. By the way, Illidan can hunt on the enemy boss, or on the Skull Golem, as you'll see here. And again, I'm going to show you the power of Thrill for Battle here. I did just use it. Well, I wasn't expecting to get stunned there, but either way, the hunt already back off a cooldown here in 30 seconds, which is beautiful. Plus, I get to use Evasion more and more often. And there's Johanna. It's not going to happen. Not going to happen this time, Johanna. Johanna's going to get almost executed. I heard two Blood for Blood go off. The hunt is back up, by the way. Unfortunately, though, I got silenced by Sylvanas at the last second, right before casting it. Still going to go after Rhaegar, though. I do still have the hunt back up. I'm going to hunt on Sylvanas, but go after Rhaegar still. Now I'm going to go back towards Sylvanas. I did use throw for battle at the last second there because I was prepared to dive on Johanna, on Sylvanas, I mean, if I needed to. So it's gonna be a 2-on-2 battle here. I do not want to fight against Nubarak while he's got the scarabs up. Jimmy's gonna use Inspire to try to catch up, but he's not gonna be able to. And the hunt already almost off of cooldown yet again. So right now, Team Bronze League up by 3 levels. Where are you going, Jimmy? Jimmy getting a way too excited there. I'm not sure what the point of that was. Here's a good opportunity for me to show you why keeping these walls intact is always going to be important, because it is going to give me the cooldown reduction that I need, especially when I was not able to get the full duration of the cooldown reduction from Throw for Battle, because everyone died. Of course, I'm going to take the Global Hunt here, and it does not look like the enemy team is taking their night camp. They're going to be relegated to try to defend against the bots, or against the bot lane right now. Yo, the Hunt already back off of cooldown again, and we're just going to take an easy peasy night camp. So Rhaegar is still, where's the rest? I'm not sure where the enemy team is. They may have just flat out given up. Now the real question is, did Husky actually do the build that I gave to him this time around? Probably not. I used the Hunt on the wrong minion there. That's okay. It looks like a Nubarak definitely did give up, which is unfortunate. Let's see, did Husky do the right build? Yes, he did, actually. Good job, Husky. Good job. So there you go. Final total is going to be 20-6. And I hope you all have had a great start to your week. Wow, 41,000 hero damage. Good lord, man. Illidan, Beast Mode, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a fantastic start to your work week or just a fantastic day. And I'll see you next time for more solo queue silliness. Until then, so long, everybody.